everyone and welcome to the forensic math. Today we are here with a report of investigation of railway accidents. Introduction. We very often come across reports of railway accidents and train derailments through print and electronic media nowadays. The loss of life and property is always irreparable. The scene of accidents leave such a terrifying impacts on our minds which are unforgettable. The government and the railways pay huge compensations to the victims of these accidents. But the loss of human life cannot be compensated in any way, which leaves behind orphan children, unfaithful widows and widowers who have to lead their lives in the absence of their kids and kins. And the scene of accident always remains a torturous, unfaithful memory in their lives. All these human sufferings can be avoided if we have a check on railway accidents and derailments by adopting appropriate measures after scientific investigations in the cause of accidents and derailments. The cause of such accidents can be of following type, which includes natural causes, human negligence, mechanical and construction faults, sabotage and railway accidents, anti-sabotage measures taken by the railways. Natural causes. It includes earthquakes, heavy rainfalls, flood, forest fire, may damage or wash away the railway tracks quickly without giving any chance to the driver for controlling the speed or for stopping the trains. The ground fog in winters, the low clouds and dust storms leading to the poor visibility can be another cause of such accidents. If high quality material is used in the construction of railway track, quake-proof measures are taken in the constructions and control speed and appropriate flood lights are used in the poor visibility, a lot of such accidents can be avoided. Human negligence. It includes 2 points that are overspeed and wrong signals. Overspeed. The drivers of the trains sometimes cross the speed limit prescribed for various areas of their operation. The less load-bearing capacity of the track may not permit safety at such high speed. The speed as prescribed for the hill tracks may also not be observed by the drivers. The speedometer graph, if records the speed at various locations and is examined by the scientific examiners, can provide a clue regarding the cause of accident if due to overspeed or otherwise. The second aspect is the wrong signals. Sometimes, where manual systems of signal is operational, human error is the main factor for causing railway accidents. One such incident had occurred at Ambala Kant railway station, where a coming train had hit the middle of the standing train due to the wrong signal, which was due to human error. Mechanical and construction faults. Brake failures and control system failures are commonly observed to be the responsible for railway accidents. Such accidents can be avoided by proper maintenance of the train and control systems and through periodical regular checkups of the brake and control system. Loose spikes fixed between rails and sleepers can also be cause of accidents or derailments. It should be checked that spikes should always be tight. Worn out jaws of sleeper cause losing of tracks, which leads to derailments. Such care must be taken at turning of tracks, especially that jaws of sleeper are not worn out, so that railway tracks are able to bear lateral thrust of running trains. Sabotage and railway accidents. Railway sabotage means criminal interference with any part of working machinery with the object of rendering it inoperational or any intended act to cause loss of life and damage to the railway property. This may lead to train wrecking by willful obstructions or tampering with pathway, works or rolling stocks, resulting in accident to trains with or without loss of life and damage. Putting obstacles on railway track. namely stones, wooden logs, and so on. Sleepers, rails, and fish plates may be removed. Turning, moving, unlocking, and diverting any points or other machinery belonging to the railways, making, showing, hiding, and removing any signals or light upon or near to any railway line or stations, causing destruction to the railway track, bridges, station installations, locomotive, signals, telecommunications, electric tractions, and substances. Anti-sabotage measures taken by railway. The railway are using long welded rails nowadays in tracks and the joints have been reduced. Reverse jaw sleepers are being affixed so as to keep the rails in position. The ends of fish plates and bolts are buried under the stones and the earth so that this cannot be removed easily. The pathway tools are kept safely and are not allowed access by the outsiders. Patrolling continues round the clock in sabotage-prone zones. Pilot trains are run before passenger trains in sensitive areas. Forensic examination of scene of railway accident. The site of accident should be jointly inspected and examined by forensic experts, police, and the railway officials. Photography and videography of the scene should be carried out meticulously, especially of the damage, affected parts, equipments, and the tracks. Rescue operation should not be adversely affected by inspecting team, and safety of luggage of the passengers and the victim should be given priority. Wheel marks on sleepers, rails, and other fittings, damage to sleepers and fittings, places of loose fitting and damage should be noted. Tampering marks, if any, on fish plates and boats should be recorded. Missing keys, if any, should be taken note. Curvature of rail should be noted on the site. Ends and jaws of the sleeper should be examined to know whether they are worn out or otherwise. Description of displaced rail head should be given. Position of wheels, coaches, and engine should be noted. Marks, if any, on rail table should be noted. Initial point of derailment should be scrutinized. Signal system and control system should be examined to know whether they are in correct operation or faulty. Use of welding sets or obstacles or explosives should be examined. Sketches should be prepared with respect to installations and damage. The speedometer graph should be analyzed in the light of speed fixed in route. In above narrated facts are kept in view for safety and examinations. The rate of railway accidents and derailments can be reduced enormously, which can save a huge loss of human lives and property. Not only this, railway should also pay heed to human resource development, and the knowledge of technical staff and drivers should be updated from time to time through refreshers courses, which will enable them to work with the latest trends in the field. The duty hours of the drivers and the operation staff should be fixed to such an extent that the physical or mental unfitness of the staff does not become a cause of accidents. Thank you for watching the video, and for more such case studies, subscribe our channel Forensic Mart and press the bell icon so that you will get notification of each and every upcoming case study.